Well, well, well. The accusations just never stop. Now, look, I've done many subliminal message videos before, and in fact, I retired the series because I simply ran out of songs. Turns out the rap community has a whole bunch of their own. I didn't know! And I think it all started with the tragic death of rapper known as XXXTentation. And ever since, people have been suggesting that he foreshadowed his own death in his songs. And I believe that this whole event sparked a whole new generation of subliminal message finders. That's the international So we're gonna test a few today, particularly the ones involving XXXTentacion. So why don't we start with X's song, Jocelyn Flores. I know your song. And this song ends with this lyric right here. I know your song. And some people have claimed that if you play that backwards, you hear this. A lot of people suggest that this was foreshadowing his death. I must go now. I admit it does kind of sound like he's saying that, but there's only one way to find out if he did. We're gonna give this the vocal test. I am going to sing the supposed subliminal message without any music so we can hear it nice and clearly to give it a proper test. And record. Must go now, must go now. So now I'm going to reverse that clip. Luckily, my program allows me to reverse clips easily. And now when we listen to this back, it should sound like I'm saying the original lyric. And if it doesn't, then we can safely assume that X didn't intentionally hide this message. Let's see if we get the original lyrics.
One word, some. One look some.
Okay, what?
One look some. One look some.
I know some. I know some.
I look some.
I don't know. I'm easily amused. Alright, so why would X hide this message in his song if it doesn't even sound like it when you play it backwards? All right, you know, I'm gonna lighten up the mood with a kind of hilarious one that I found. This song is by the rapper known as Juice WRLD, or Juice WRLD. Yeah, you know what? F vowels. But anyways, this one is from Juice WRLD's song, Lucid Dreams. So these are the regular lyrics.
You made my heart break, you made my heart break.
Apparently, if you play that backwards, you get this hilarious subliminal message. Okay, so a couple of questions. What the hell is a cowman? And second of all, why would Juice WRLD leave subliminal messages of said cowman? Mooing. I guess this one's worth the vocal test. Yeah, cowman mooing. Yeah, bro, y'all man mooing. All right, reverse flippity flop review. Okay, the beginning was like super dead on though. You made my headache. It is kind of slurry though. But that almost sounds like the original. Are you telling me that maybe Juice WRLD was trying to tell us something about cowmen trying to take over the world? That's a new conspiracy for ya. Now, what would a good subliminal message video be without Kanye West? This one is in his song, Power with Jay-Z. So here's the part being accused.
The clock's ticking, I just count the hours.
But if you listen to that backwards. Okay, whoa, 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 whoa! really, Kanye West leaving satanic subliminal messages. He believes he's God. Why am I satanic? It's gospel. Duh. Time for Tsetlakov. Nope, that's not a Russian name. That's vocal test backwards. Why am I satanic? It's gospel. All right, put my thang down, flip it, and reverse it. Let's review. I'm so sorry. What? Something about hot dog chicken and dip the ow. Just no. Just no. Now, even XXXTentation couldn't escape the satanic message accusations. This one is in his song, No Pulse. This part right here. Definitely a pretty sad line, but this is what you get if you play it backwards, apparently. I definitely heard that one. It's definitely... Satan is bad. All right, to Tsetlakov time.
Satan is bad.
All right, reverse and review. I think you're starting to get the process. All right, I might have to cancel forever.
Absent is oh.
Nope, nope, that didn't sound at all like that.
Absent is oh.
Might have to dis. Held.
Absent is oh.
All right, well, based on the evidence, I'm gonna have to say that this one also was not intentional. Oh, wow, is it that time already? It's time for you guys to a burskbus. But yeah, just know that every one of you means a lot to subscribe, so hit a burkspus. Now how about my man, Lil Wayne? Look, I owe my career to Lil Wayne, all right? And now he's being accused of having satanic messages in his songs. He may suck at guitar, but he is not satanic. Now this is in his song, Lay It Down, with this part right here.
Lay it down, lay it down, you hoes lay it down.
And yes, that is the correct pronunciation of hose.
You hose.
No offensive lyrics! But anyways, if you play that backwards, you apparently get this. Okay. Okay, to me it sounds like more like he's saying, I've been so ugly. But we'll give it to Tsetlakov to settle it once and for all. I've been so unholy. I've been. Flip sandwiches. Let's see if we lay it down, hoes. Lay it down. What I got there was lay back, damn horse, lay back. You horse, lay back. Lil Wayne may be guilty of guitar butchery, but he is not guilty of satanic sublims. Now this next one is from XXXTentacion. I'm getting really good at saying that, by the way. This one is in his song, No Pulse. And this one led a lot of people to believe that X is still alive. Here's the song forward. But if you play that backwards, apparently this is what you get. Pretty eerie, if I do say so myself. I will admit that it did kind of sound like he's saying that. I'm still hesitant to say that it was intentional, so let's give it the Tsetlakov.
Hey, I'm still alive.
All right, reverse and see what we get.
Fellas, my
what?
Fellas, my I'm not that smart. Hey.
That's all I got out of that. So what do you say we use a speech recognition program and see if they hear the original lyrics? Put it up to the speaker.
Fellas, my
F It's not yet.
My text-to-speech dropped the F-bomb! How did it get the F-word out of that? Sounds more like I don't know. And based on that, I can't conclude that he hid this message intentionally. You know, I gotta admit something. I'm not a fan of rap, like, at all. But I must say that I thoroughly enjoyed X's music. You could just tell he put his whole heart and soul into his music, which literally is changing the whole way I look at rap. But anyways, before I get all sappy and like teary, let's move on to the next song. Now, we gotta end with the juggernaut of them all. The song that I believe sparked this whole new subliminal messages in modern rap. It's XXXTentation's song, Sad. Here's the forward lyric.
I'm fine, but it's torture.
And here's the subliminal message backwards.
So sick, help my mind. So sick, help my mind.
It sounds like he's saying, help my asthma.
Help my asthma.
Yeah, I have a feeling this one's not even gonna be close, but we'll give it a try. I'm so sick, help me. Let's see what kind of train wreck we can come up with this time.
Yeah, boy, Jesus.
What was that, Game Boy Jesus?
Yeah, boy, Jesus.
I guess X was not talking about asthma. He was talking about Game Boys and Jesus.
So sick, help my asthma.
Alright, now best for last. This one is really, really eerie from Sad again. This is the main one that led people to believe that he was foreshadowing his own death in his backwards song. And it's this part right here.
If you ever try to let go, I'm sad, I know ya. I'm sad, I know ya.
But if you play that backwards, you get this. Yeah, frickin' creepy, right? I mean, I definitely hear that, but let's give it the Tisset Lakov just to make sure.
I know you want me to die soon. I know you want me to die soon. I'm dead, lost faith.
All right, flip my gip and review.
The F solid ma, no sad day ma weon, no sad day ma weon.
Salamonion? What does that mean?
The F solid ma, no sad day ma weon, no sad day ma weon.
If you ever solid ma, salamonia, salamonia.
Sad day ma weon.
Alright, so since we get salamonia instead of the original lyrics, I gotta go with no on this one too. Now, we can't say with 100% certainty that these weren't intentional, but at least with these tests, we have a little bit more info to go by, and I fully understand that I'm super late to the whole XXXTentacion thing, but it's never too late to keep someone's memory alive, so let's just enjoy the music. Let's stop playing it in reverse and trying to find words out. Just listen to it forwards and enjoy it, okay? That's what he would want for his legacy, all right? But I would love to hear your opinions on the whole matter. Hit up the comments section and keep the conversation going.